What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about wheel spoilers. What are they and what do they do? So what are wheel spoilers? And it's a bit of a funny name. They also go by a name, wheel deflectors. So let's say we have the front of a car and then we have the windshield, the roof, and then we come to the wheels. And the flow is coming this way. And we have the wheels in here. So typically without something called a wheel spoiler or a wheel deflector, the air will come along and will be deflected down upwards and it'll come around underneath and hit the wheels, the front of them. What this does is that the flow here will start to decelerate and get quite high pressure on this surface. You also have separated flow around the back, and that means that here you have low pressure. So that results in the wheel itself having quite high drag. That's mainly due to pressure drag, high pressure up front, low pressure downstream. The overall net pressure is like the resistive force, and that's drag. So there's something called a wheel deflector. So let's say we have, I'll draw it again just to get a little bit of a cleaner look. So let's say we have, again, the wheels here. And now, instead of having the flow coming along here, coming underneath and hitting the wheel directly, we put this little flat plate here. And it's usually about 10 centimeters wide and about maybe 3-4 centimeters, maybe 3 centimeters, let's say, in depth. It depends how much you want to change the flow. So by having the flow hit this deflector or the spoiler, this then results in the flow coming around the sides of the wheel. So you don't have nearly as much flow hitting the front of the wheel. As a result, there's not nearly as much flow crashing into the front, increasing the pressure, and that way the pressure on the front is a little bit lower, which means that the overall drag, mainly due to the pressure drag, drops. And that is how the wheel spoiler affects the drag of the wheels, and then as a result, the car. So the wheels in general make up about 25% of the drag of a regular car. So to reduce the drag by a little bit is still quite a big deal in terms of the car. So we can also have them on the rear wheels as well, which is quite common. It's becoming a lot more common these days as well. So we have, again, these flat plates down here that pop out. And again, they're about 10, 15 centimeters wide and 2 or 3 centimeters deep. And so any flow that's coming along here can also be redirected around the wheel. These are not as common as the front wheel front deflectors, front spoilers. I would say pretty much in the last 2 or 3 years, I haven't seen a new car without these. I have seen some new cars without these, but they are both very beneficial usually. So what are the kind of drag reductions we can see from these spoilers? Well, usually in the drag coefficient, we see drag reductions of about 10 to 15 counts. So 10 to 15 counts of an entire car is quite good. If you have a car which is 250 counts, so 0.25, that's like 4% of the car's drag that you can reduce just by putting these little things on. So that is what a wheel spoiler is, or wheel deflector, and what they are and what they do. So if you like this video, make sure to like it. If you like this, click the subscribe button, and I'll see you next video. Peace out.